Hello everyone, this is Learn GIS channel and my name is Yaroslav. In this video, we will try to perform some supervised classification of satellite image. In previous video, we tried to do some unsupervised classification and classify all the water bodies. But what if we want to classify forest and to do it more precisely? For that, we can do some supervised classification. There are a lot of options to do supervised classification in Quantum GIS. We could use Orfeo toolbox, using training image classifier and then image classification tool. Also, we could use some plugins in Quantum GIS. I suggest to use plugins because it's a lot simpler than training classifiers and gives pretty good results. So, open plugins, manage and install plugins. And let's search for plugins that do classification. Name it class, and we here see some classification plugins. The most powerful classification plugin is the semi-automatic classification plugin. It has a lot of options, it gives a lot of possibilities to classify, punch sharp, prepare a lot of satellite image, including Landsat 8 image. But what if we need simple classification without a lot of options? For that, I suggest to use the ZSACA classification tool. It's really great. Let's install this plugin. Close it when it's installed. And this plugin, it could perform supervised classification in very simple algorithm. So here we see interface of this plugin. Here it's settings. We could open it and see it have several classifiers. It's Gaussian mixture model, random forest, SVM, and k-nearest neighbor. Let's test default algorithm for classification and how it works. First of all, we need to choose our raster image. We have several raster images. Let's try Landsat 8 multispectral raster images that we created in previous video. Next, it's our vector layer. It's our reference classes. We could digitize it from scratch, or we could use our results of manual classification. We have here some forest, some agricultural land, and some water body. Only make result of our unsupervised classification invisible. So we could use this as our training classes, but this classification tool, it needs some field for our classification values, and it should be integer. So that's why we open our vector layer. Then we to go into editing mode. Again, open attribute table, add some new field, not a feature, we add in new field, and name it our class column. Class 1, for example. Okay, and forest should be 1, agricultural land 2, and water bodies 3. So we just separate integer values. Save it. And now we choose here class. Here we must choose our class 1 field. We don't see it because we don't reload our layer, so we remove it. Okay, and add it again. Our class layer. Okay. The symbology of this layer, it's not preserved, but we don't need it actually. So we choose class, class 1, and now we save our new file. Let's call it supervised, because it's supervised classification would be. And press button this button to perform classification. Again, it's very fast, and you see result of our classification. You already see that we here have classified all the forest in pretty great accuracy. But let's try to see how it looks like. So we could make this layer invisible and see that all the forests are classified. Also, we could change our classified layer a little so it even looks better. So open it properties. Then again change to single band pseudo color. Here we see we have three classes from 0 to 2. Okay, discrete, and it should be equal integer for three classes. Try to classify it manually, or we could do it not manually and just value 0, value 1, value 2. Let's try that. Okay. And all the forest, it's our value 1, all the other entities are value 0, and also we could add another value, for example, value 3, try it, and all the water bodies would be this value. We could change colors, water bodies should be blue, even more blue, okay. Then second value, we could change some color also, it's also water bodies, forest, it should be green, okay, and all the other values, it could be transparent, okay, okay. So now we see our result. Also we could make transparent all the other values that we don't need, and left only forest and only water bodies, and see how precise our classification. So water bodies, it's pretty great classified. All the green areas, all the forest, also classified pretty good. But as you see in the settlements, there are also a lot of pixels. That's because there are actually some vegetation on the settlements, and that's why it classified. But anyways, result of classification are pretty good, so we could use it for some area calculation, some visualization, and other purposes. So that's the general idea of supervised classification. We just choose some reference classes and then perform some classification algorithm. Like that, we use Gaussian mixture model, but we could use any other of the algorithms. That's the idea of supervised classification. Thank you for attention. In next video, we will try to export results of our classification.